How's it going, guys? Dre here, and welcome back to Grim Knights. Today, we're gonna get out once again, and, we should definitely be able to survive longer than our first run. That was definitely a learning experience. Now I know a little bit more about the game, and, I'm excited to play this, because this is an awesome game. Now, the biggest thing that I did wrong before was really my placement of characters. Now, each character has their own unique features. As you can see, plus one on mining any ore or stone. This is going to be a good character to have. But this comes down to RNG as well. Sometimes I've had really good characters at the start, other times not so well. Skill with the hammer, so this is going to be our builder. Again, skill with the hammer, so we'll have to get this guy doing something else for right now. Tough skin, plus one to armor. Now, I did screw up my warriors as well. I want any sort of damage increasing unit to be an archer. Obviously, that's our damage dealers. And then anyone with armor or HP, I'm gonna focus mostly on HP because I don't think armor is really that good. But anyone with a lot of HP will be our spearmen or our frontlines, our melee units, and a qualified gold miner. So we didn't get any tree cutters or farmers, which is actually what I wanted at the start. Of course we didn't get that, so we have to start off with what we have at our disposal. Now, what we want at the start is definitely a farm. We're going to put the farm here once again, and I'm going to do something a little different this time. I want to get my mine down early, but I'm going to put the mine at the front of our hill here. This is where we usually hold out, and I'm going to hold out there again with another archer tower. But right now, I really want to get my vitals down, so I want to get a farm up. I need to get another house up, too. You know what? Where's that other builder? All right, there we go. We got the other builder. I guess we could technically upgrade the other house, too. Do we have everything we need to do that? Yeah, let's do that as well, just so we're getting units as quickly as possible. The biggest thing with this game, I find, is you need to constantly be recruiting new people, getting rid of the people you don't really like, and that's what we're going to focus mostly on today. So we got to throw some random people in the field. We don't have any gold right now, so we may as well throw that guy in there. Iron or stone? Let's get this guy starting to work on some stone. We also need a woodcutter here. We'll just use the armor lady because I'm probably going to get rid of her. Like I said, I want to get mostly HP buffed characters for my melee units. But yeah, I really want to focus on the food. I want to get a nice collection of food going before we expand too much. What is this guy doing? Skilled with the hammer, so I guess we'll keep that guy as the builder and we'll continue to build. The next thing we're going to need is a barracks. Let's get this kind of at the front lines too, so I want to make sure I have enough room though, so we're going to put this here because I want to put multiple towers down as well, and that kind of reminds me let's actually hit this rock instead because I want to deplete that rock so we have space in here to put two towers down because we're definitely going to need more of a military. The mistake I made last time was not preparing enough. The knights get extremely hard really, really quickly in this game, and if you're new to this game, I do recommend you go check out the first video, but basically this is a lot like Kingdom. Too many different games called Kingdom, but yeah, basically we have waves of undead coming at night, and we have to deal with it. Look at that! This is exactly what I wanted. Good old mountain hill here will be our woodcutter. We finally got one. That's really lucky. It's hard for me to find woodcutters, I find. And I have played a little bit of this game off recording, so I do know a little bit more now, by the way. So we should hopefully run a little bit better. I think I'm just gonna get rid of this person. Well, we'll wait. Let's just put her in the field for right now. No sense getting rid of a good hand if we have enough, placements to recruit more people. But yeah, what I'm looking for right now is some damage dealers. We're gonna need at least a couple, archers tonight. Probably more than that. Let me actually prepare the, archer tower as well. Where's my, builder? Actually, we have a guy coming in here. I'll probably just get this guy to build. Not too strong, but very deadly. Perfect! That is the perfect archer unit. Archers are generally not gonna get damaged anyways, unless, you know, shit hits the fan. So, definitely want to get this guy as an archer. So, let's actually go bring him over. And now that this guy's done... Oh, that's right. He was building over here. Let's start preparing the archer tower as well. So we're going to put it right on the hillside here. I feel like this is a good way to do it because we have the extra height against the enemy. And like I said, we're going to make an archer. We probably should get a melee unit as well. I'm going to look for a better unit than what we have, though. A new villager has just come. Man, the villagers come quick, so we're going to have to get rid of one. Extraordinary healthy. Look at this. I am getting really lucky right now. That is the perfect melee character that I wanted. So we got really lucky with the RNG there, and we have the perfect archer as well. So we're going to put the archer in the top tower. Let's just get this guy chopping this tree here because I want to chop this tree down out as quickly as possible. And what we're going to actually do, if we have enough of the resources, I'm going to upgrade this right away. This is something else I didn't do, that's very important, because when we get this fire here, you actually get fire arrows. And obviously, that's huge. It gives a death over time, which is obviously some great added damage. So yeah, we have a good baseline going. The next thing I do want to do, is this the builder? Oh no, this is the melee unit. I'm going to make him the melee unit. The builder is right over here, cutting the tree down. The next thing I want to do is get the mine down, and I want to explore the mine as quickly as possible. If we can get to that gold quick, that means we can upgrade our kingdom quicker. So, we'll put the mine entrance. Ooh, it's actually, damn it, it's bigger than I thought it was. I wanted to put it at the front lines because if we ever do get some zombies inside the mine, the melee units only have a small transfer time to get over to defend them. So what I think I'll have to do is just put it over here. It's still pretty close to the front lines at least, and we can put it down right away instead of waiting for this tree and rock to go away. Alright, but there we go. We have a very basic fighting unit right now. That's better than nothing, and we're still waiting on one more person to come in. I'm not going to speed up the days as well. I feel like that's another mistake I made. You can fast forward to nighttime, which will give you some extra gold, but I feel like looking for the perfect villagers and spending your whole day doing that is the better option. So we're gonna start getting rid of some of these guys. I do not need another gold miner right now. I do not even have my mine set up yet, so we're gonna kill that one off and keep going as we are. There's the mine done, so we're gonna actually get this guy to kind of explore right now because we don't have anything unlocked, and we'll start digging this out. Now, what I want in mines, we need the fishing wells because that's gonna give us lots more food. Obviously, gold and iron is gonna be a big commodity that we need as well. I think I need, what do I need? Oh, it doesn't actually say until I have a unit there. What are the requirements to make a melee unit? But I think it does use a little bit of iron. I could be wrong with that, though. Don't quote me on it. So yeah, main goal right now is to get village level 2. I want to get that as quickly as possible. I also want to obviously work on my army as much as possible. But village level 2 will unlock a bunch of new stuff. Of course, the first thing I hit is goblins. This is what I was talking about, and this is why I want the melee units nice and close to the mine. That way we can deal with them quickly. But yeah, those guys will kill any sort of peasants that are in there. So yeah, we gotta get a melee unit down. It looks like we got a guy coming in. Let's see what he's doing. Let me show you how to use a pickaxe, plus one mining any ore or stone. We might, oh god. Oh. Let's actually make sure. Okay, we're okay. We might need to get a healer early though, because he took a lot more damage than I thought he would. We'll take him to the front lines. We will have to get a healer soon. I'm gonna actually just get rid of this guy for right now, because we have to continue to get guys coming in. Actually, you know what? Let's just upgrade the house once again. We can upgrade those houses once more as well. You can upgrade them up to 3 times. All right, but back in the mine, exploring, we gotta find that gold, man. And if we can find it early, that just means we are going to earn that much more early on. I would like to get one more archer before nighttime too, so that's the ultimate goal. We might need to make one of these basic units of archer if we do need to. All right, and look at that. Got lucky, got some gold right away. We're going to continue to expand out this. Where is my gold miner? Probably in the fields here. Yes, qualified gold miner. Perfect. We're going to bring that guy over. Get him on the actual resource that he's supposed to be on. Be nice to get a +2 gold miner. I think the max you can get is +2. Really tough and really slow. +2 to armor, moves 40% slower. I don't really like that unit. I'm also not going to go crazy with melee units. Whenever you make a warrior in this game, they eat x2 the food. I feel like melee units are not the answer here. I want to get lots of archers, so I'm looking for those damage dealers. We might actually put down another tavern as well, because then we get units twice as fast. How much does it cost to actually do that? Now that I think about that, that's actually a damn good idea. So, let's get Tough Skin over here. What is it? I just want to make sure it's not too much. 50 and 25, that's not crazy at all. So we're gonna get 2 taverns here. That means we'll recruit twice as fast. And like I said, I'm trying to get through these people as quickly as possible, finding the right people for the right job. And it looks like we did hit a well here. That's going to be more food than what a farm gives us. This is a really lucky run so far. I'm gonna continue to expand this out. Where's my gold miner? I didn't put him on there? I thought I did. All right, get him on there now. And another new villager has arrived. Got some wood chopping skills. Well, you can stay right there and chop wood to your heart's content. I do want to get definitely someone else in the field. Maybe I should get someone working. Actually, being that this isn't a farmer, I don't think. Yeah, it's just skill with the hammer. We're going to put him on the water well here because you get more food doing this than on the farm. But now we just have to worry about goblins invading this thing because we could actually die. So let's just make sure. Okay, another water well. Yes, please. So now what I'm going to do is start doing the second floor of this. That way, if goblins do spawn, Goblins in this game, by the way, can't climb ladders for some reason, so we should be safe to be in here, and we can continue to expand out the mine as these guys are working and pulling up food and gold. Another guy coming in. What's this? Skilled with the hammer once again. We're not going to get rid of that guy just because we need some people in the fields, but basically anyone that's in the fields that's not a farmer, we can get rid of really quickly as they're not really fitting into our kingdom. All right, I do definitely need one more archer, though, so hopefully we can get lucky and get one soon. Oh, I didn't even see the guy here. I'm sorry. Tough skin, plus one to armor. Again, don't want armor. I want the HP buff. I feel like that's better than armor. I really have to test that out, though, to truly know. I just think that that's the case. Okay, we got some stones down below. We're just going to continue to stay up here and then unlock all this. I think we can go to floor 3, and then we have to upgrade our kingdom to get to the 4th floor. But you can dig quite deep in this game, as you can see. And yeah, that tavern upgrade was a great idea. Villagers are coming like crazy. Plus one when mining iron. That's something else we have to find. So we're going to keep that guy. We'll throw him in the field for now. But once we find some iron, we'll throw him on it. Well, goddamn, I don't even know if we're going to need a farm. I don't think these streams deplete, by the way. And we get plus 2 food in them as compared to plus 1 in the field. So I might just get... We may as well just get... I know there's one miner in here. We may as well get him down here working on the stream here because it's more food in the bank. So this is... we're getting pretty lucky with the placements here. It is turning nighttime, though, so that means I gotta get... Yes! Okay, I was just talking about this. I gotta get one more archer. Look at that! What a warrior! And that's what I wanted, another 100%. I think that's as good as you can get for extra damage. You can get 50% ones as well. But yeah, definitely gonna make this guy an archer, and I think we should be okay for night one with just this small amount of troops. Obviously, if we can get more, though, that would be great, but we have to get lucky and get the right people for that. We do got some iron down there, so we can get the dude on the iron. I was gonna get him on the stream, but I'd rather start getting some iron in the bank so we can work on our army a little bit more. And it is nighttime, so I gotta turn on all my lights, by the way. You can turn on the lights of the guys. It's gonna be really dark regardless, though. Do we got anyone coming in yet? Doesn't look like they're invading just yet, so we still got a long time before they come. All right, and already we've maxed out our population, so once again, we got lots of wood right now, so let's just upgrade both of these homes, and there we go. Okay, so we got up to 18. We should get quite a few throughout the night, too, so that's good. We're mining. What's this guy doing? Oh, yeah, that's the guy that's expanding out the cave. So what I'm going to do is expand out this one. Whoops, didn't mean to go upstairs. I'm going to expand out this one over here. That way, if there is goblins in there, they don't infect the guy that's mining iron right now. The tomb is growing restless. There it is. They're coming in. And I'll do my best to light this area, guys. All I can do is turn on these guys' lights, and that's it. But it's better than nothing. Another guy coming in. What's up, dude? Who are you? Skilled stone miner. Okay, well, actually, we could use you for a little bit. I got a little stone around, so we'll throw him on there for right now. And look at that. Some more gold down there. That's perfect. All right, we're going to open this one up. I just got to be careful and cautious and make sure I'm around when this thing spawns, just in case zombies pop out. We're going to equip torches in here so I can see a little bit as well. There we go. We got more people coming in, it looks like. I think I saw somebody anyways. And yes, there he is right there. Tough skin plus one to armor. We're going to just kill off that unit. Again, we're getting kind of to the point where I have to start killing off units because, as you can see, my food's keeping stable, but I want to actually start growing. The scale is really slow, moves 40% slower. No buffs there, so we may as well totally get rid of that character. Knows how to take a punch, but not how to run. Plus 2 to armor, moves 40% slower. We're going to kill off that unit as well. And here comes our first one. As you can see, these guys do catch on fire now. We should be totally fine for this wave. As long as there's... Actually, that's a boomer right there. I think we should still survive it just fine. We have 2 100% archers, so that's basically like having 4 archers in terms of damage. You can see they're doing like 10 damage a shot, which is obviously pretty damn good. So there we go. 8, 10. Yeah, so about 8 to 10 damage a shot. God damn it! Remember when I said I should pay attention to this mine? That's exactly why my dude died. My one iron miner that I have freaking died. Of course he did. Ah, that's frustrating. Oh my god, these guys got through? Wait, what are you killing? Sometimes they attack the bunnies. I think there was a bunny on the ground. I can't assume a guy got through that far because my melee unit's right here. I have no idea what happened. God damn it, we got more goblins though. That sucks. And I can't actually get rid of the goblins right now because we're busy fighting the front line. So we're gonna have to wait for that. Maybe I should just get a warrior that is inside the mine. That might actually be a smart idea once we get a little bit more going on. Now, we have another gold miner. I'd love to throw him on the gold, but can't really do that right now because there's goblins in there. So we'll just throw him in the fields, try and collect some more food. Actually, no, that's right. We have an extra stream here that's safe at least. So we'll bring him in and bring him to the stream. And then once this is safe, we'll put the gold miner on floor 2. There goes our first tree. That was with the actual tree cutter, right? Yep. All right, so we'll get the other tree down. Now, we are going to have to start searching for trees. We are getting a nice collection of trees going on, though, or at least wood. All right, is there anybody coming anytime soon? Yeah, we got some guys here. You know what? Those are little guys, though. I want to get this done quickly because I want to start expanding out the third floor. So I'm going to take a risk here, bring my one melee unit, which is still damaged, by the way. There's only two goblins down here, so I think we're totally fine. A new villager has arrived. We'll check out the villagers in a little bit. I just want to get rid of these goblins and get this guy back to the front lines as quickly as possible. That way I can still work in my cave here. All right, there we go. He can't even hit us. Perfect. All right, it's cleared, and back to the front lines you go. And let's get this gold miner down, starting to get some more gold. We're already at 41 gold. I think we need 100 to upgrade, so we should get this done quite quickly. And being that we've pretty much done the second floor, let's start working on the third. We can obviously expand this out more later, but I want to keep these guys safe. Got another iron miner. I'm actually using my other miner. I forgot I had this guy, which is plus one to any ore or stone, so he's even better than an ordinary iron miner. But I guess I can put him on stone. So yeah, let's get these guys going. We got two more guys coming in. We got the front lines coming. That's a boomer right there, so we gotta get that guy down quick. As you can see, no chance at all for them to get close to us. So upgrading that tower early, I think, is really, really smart. So we're gonna put this guy on stone since he can mine anything and get plus one, and put this guy on iron as he gets plus one with iron. We're still expanding out the third floor. Look at that, though. Another well. I didn't even notice that. And is that... I think that's more gold. Yeah, that's definitely gold there, right? So we got even more gold. We're getting really lucky with this cave, guys. We seriously don't even need a farm. Let's actually get these farmers inside the cave on these watering holes because we may as well. Is anybody else coming? It looks like we have a small wave, and I think that's it for tonight. So we survived the first night. First night's never really hard, but it gets progressively harder very quickly in this game. For the record, to win this game, you only need to survive 13 days. So kind of you can judge how hard it gets and how quickly it gets. Excellent stone miner, plus two when mining stone. Yes, please. We got another piece of stone in here. So we're kind of like dwarves right now. I got most of the people underground, but that's where a lot of our resources are. So let's keep doing it. Ooh, and awesome gold mining skills. Yes, please. Okay, this is better than any other gold miner. I'm going to take a risk and go down to the third floor with this one. And we're going to continue to expand out. I'm going to focus on it, though, and not miss it this time. Really tough skin on this one, plus two to armor. Ooh, with plus two, that might be worth it, but no. I'm still going to kill it off. I want to focus on the HP, man. All right, and good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is so weird. I have, like, maybe five people above ground right now. Everybody's mining, but we are getting so many resources so quickly. This is actually amazing, and I got so many more spots in here. Okay, we got more people coming in. I guess I could use another gold miner. I mean, there's another piece of gold here, technically. And I guess the quicker we get it, the better. So let's bring this guy over and bring him down. He's expendable anyway, so if I do spawn a goblin and he's too slow to get away, I mean, he dies, basically. All right, looks like it's time for a new home, too. Let's get this guy to build it. We don't need to rush build the home anyways. I have expanded out my bottom floor. Almost done, as you can see. Just keeping an eye out for this. I'm getting a little worried, though. It's midday, and we still haven't found any more warrior units, so we might, like I said, have to convert some of these basic units to it. If push comes to shove, I'm hoping to get at least four archers today, so we really do need that more freaking gold. Are you kidding me? This is amazing! Now, I don't even know if I should expand out anymore. I think we got everything we need, at least for right now, so I think I'm gonna chill out a little bit, mine all these resources, and then when we have more of an army, at least we can keep a few units down here so we don't lose all of our units. So yeah, back to the top we go, and I guess I can focus on building. All right, Polly's not the perfect unit, but she's got 50% more health points. That's better than nothing, so we're gonna make that another melee unit. I'm gonna have about, I wanna say, at most, maybe four melee units, and then I wanna get like 50 archers, something crazy like that. So melee units are a dime a dozen. Hopefully we can upgrade her later, but I haven't got any damage producers yet, so hopefully soon. Oh, new villager has just arrived. What is this guy? Eats more to stay tough. Okay, definitely don't want these units. I just feel like food is too important to have a unit like this, and especially considering if we did make that a warrior, it would eat times four, because warriors eat times two already, so that is just too much for me. Now we have another melee unit, though, and at least this one's full health. Again, we're gonna need healers as well. I'm gonna wait maybe till one more day to do that, unless we find that we have time to do it. But I really want to focus on the archers. Plus one when mining any ore or stone. That's better than plus one when mining gold, so I'm gonna kill off that gold unit and then just upgrade it to this unit. That way he's more useful once we don't need gold. By the way, we're almost already at 100 gold. That is so damn quick. So we're definitely going to be able to expand out our headquarters today. And there we have it. We are rich. And that means we can expand out. What do we have to actually expand out? I guess technically we can upgrade either of these. We're going to upgrade that one. Can we upgrade this one as well? No, we can't. So it looks like this is now considered my headquarters. We have another one as well. Now with that upgrade, we can also upgrade this. We need some 20 more gold, and then we get better units. If we can get better units on day two, that would feel amazing. It's only going to take 20 gold. We should get there soon. Please be a damage dealer. Bit of a limp, moves 20% slower. That is totally pointless, so unfortunately, we got to get rid of her. Oh, that's right. I have wooden spikes unlocked, too. I forgot I got unlocks with this upgrade, too. So, where's my builder? I put my builder in the field, I think. I'm also throwing some random guys in the field because Mogha is going to come soon, and we can give people to Mogha for potions. So I'm going to build some of these spike things. These actually damage the units as well. It's only 15 wood, and as you can see, we got lots of wood right now. So I'm going to start kind of supporting this. Oh, look at that. I just talked about Mogha, and here he comes. So now we got to get rid of some of these units. Perfect time. Are you any good? No, nothing special at all. So we got two totally pointless and a qualified gold miner. We're going to get rid of these guys to Mogha. We're just going to bring them down here, and Mogha will hopefully give us some decent potions. Now, this guy, I want to start building these things, so we're going to put one right within our range, obviously. We want to stop them before they get to us, so let's keep building these. These things are built really quickly, as you can see. It takes 15 each, so I think it's definitely worth it to do these. And this should be good. See you later, residents. Enjoy being eaten. Thanks for doing that, because I need those potions, man. I'm not getting lucky with the damage dealers today, unfortunately. Okay, sometimes it's hard to find where I can place these. There we go. We can put one up there. All right, who else do we got today? Excellent stone miner. Plus two? All right, I'll keep you. You are a decent stone miner, and we'll just get rid of someone else, I think. Actually, that tree just fell, so how are you a good axe cutter? Oh, yeah, you're my best axe cutter, so I'm going to actually get rid of... Are both of these guys axe cutters? Yeah, got some wood chopping skills. We're going to bring this guy down here, too. You know what? Let's actually get rid of both. Mogha might already be almost there, though. Hopefully, these guys make it there in time and get eaten, because I want to get lots of potions. Those potions are extremely good. Okay, I think that's enough reinforcement for today. I don't want to spend all my wood, because wood's hard to come by once we use it all, obviously. Let's just put one more up here. What I might do is put, like, a no man's land in between the tower and our base. That way, we have kind of a last line of defense if we do need it. So this guy, he's all out of wood, isn't he? Oh, no, that's right. We got this wood over here. This guy's really slow. Or girl, I should say. We're going to kill off that one. Skilled stone miner. We have lots of those. We don't need that. So at this point, I'm getting really selective with the units that I want to give. All right, Mogha's almost here. I think these guys are going to make it. He will devour anyone within 10 seconds. And yeah, these guys are all going to be eaten. Now let's actually bring out one of my warriors, too, to pick up that loot, because I got to pick it up as long as he doesn't get eaten, too. Yeah, looks like we're doing quite well. We have 48 gold. That just reminds me. Let's upgrade this as well. There we go. Now we can make better units. So I want to do that before the end of today. We're going to take both of these guys, at least do the archers. And did Mogha eat them yet? No, Mogha's almost there. I'm trying to do 10 things at once here. I do want to watch them get devoured, though. Give me the good potions, man. Enjoy your delicious meal. Is that it? Okay, I thought he wasn't going to eat the rest, but there we go. Mogha leaves an 8. So it looks like you can just keep stacking them, because it doesn't count down until he eats the final one, which is pretty damn crazy. So now we're going to get Arbalest. I actually put both of them in. You can queue up multiples. I didn't know that. That's actually really cool. This guy's really slow. Pointless unit. Come on, man. We need some damage dealers. Let me show you how to use a pickaxe. Nope. Gonna get rid of that guy as well. Okay. Mogha has left us, and we got lots of potions to use. So what we're gonna do is put damage dealing potions on, obviously, our archers, and defense potions on our melee units. I mean, that's just common sense. So how many did we get here? We should have 5, and yes, we did. Perfect. And now we have the Arbalest, aka a crossbowman. So what are these potions? Plus 15% more damage, plus 50% more HP, and plus 50% to armor. So that's a jack of all trades. These other two are plus 2 armor. So I'm gonna throw, I'm gonna throw this one on this guy, this one on that guy, and I'm going to use these as damage increase. So does it actually say how much damage it has? No. Let's put the other one on this guy. There we go. So we have some buffed archers that do even more damage now. We gotta get some more archers, though. I'm gonna have to choose something soon. Split can mine anything with ease. We have a lot of those guys already. There we go! 100% more damage. That's what I like to see. I at least need to get 4 today, if not more, preferably. So let's actually see, how much does it cost to do this? 15 food? Wow, 15 food? I didn't realize it took food to do these guys. And we need iron now. As you can see, I only got 33 iron. So iron's gonna be my next major thing that I need if I want to equip these guys right. So, we should probably expand this place out soon. Is this an iron miner? Please tell me this guy's a miner. Yeah, okay. Plus one mining iron. So, we have the right guy for the job, but I am going to need to expand this place out. Let's bring one of these guys in here, and I'm going to focus on expanding out maybe the front, the top column. Because all I have up here is a couple fishers and a gold miner. New villager has arrived. Perfect. So yeah, we're gonna put my guy right here, and this is the guy that's building, right? Let me show you how to use a pickaxe. No, he must have ran out of rock. I'm gonna put him on the gold then. We should have a builder somewhere. Is this him? Yes, there we go. There's my builder I was looking for. So we're just gonna have this melee unit here as a safety net in case I miss the fact that this opens up with goblins. You never know when goblins are gonna come. All right, pickaxe again. Man, I'm getting a lot of miners. Am I in a freaking miner town or something? All right, there we go. That's exactly what I needed. More iron. Perfect. So we can get multiple people doing iron. It looks like I cannot go any further with the mine. So only thing we can do is go down, and I'll just keep my guy by the stairs here in case any goblins do come. What is this guy? Qualified gold miner. So I must have got rid of that gold. Being that we have so many miners, I'm going to have to start killing some of these guys off. I do not need gold miners now. I need jack of all trades or iron miners. So who do we have in here? Plus two in mining stone. Plus two is really good. I don't want to get rid of plus two. What's this other guy mining stone? What is he? Plus two as well. So is there any stone above that I can hit? There actually isn't. So I'm actually running out of stone. I have so much stone in the bank. We're just going to get rid of this guy too. I hate doing that because he's a really good unit, but that's more food that I need. All right, there's some more gold. Gold is not what I need right now. We have all the gold we needed for the upgrade, so I actually don't even think we really need gold anymore. Qualified iron miner. Perfect. That's what I needed. It's nighttime now, so I think I might just make a random unit, an archer unit, just for now. So yeah, we got a woodcutter here. We're just going to throw him as an archer for right now, and we'll obviously banish him later and upgrade to a better unit. Just because I want to be safe, I think having 4 archers should be okay for day 2. I was hoping to have more, honestly, though, so we got to get lucky tomorrow and get a bunch of damage dealers. So it says we had a new enemy. This is the Codex, by the way. I didn't know about this before, but do we have... We don't have Mogha. Oh, we can actually... I wonder if we could kill Mogha. He's got 1,000 HP. Damage, who knows? Oh, that would be a fun challenge to do. I think we have the abomination coming. Is that probably what it's talking about? Oh, yeah. We got a frig. We got a really big amount of troops coming in. I'm actually kind of scared now that I saw that. We have 4 archers, but please be a damage dealer. Oh, actually a farmer? I'm okay with a farmer. I don't have any of those, so I need more of those. And another farmer. Okay, this is actually good because I was slowly running out of food. Or slowly, well, depleting food, not running out. We also got the enemies coming. I'm scared about these big guys here. Looks like we can hit within range of our barricades, though, so that's good. All we have is that big guy, so I think we should be okay with 4. I don't see us not having a problem, because we have 4 upgraded archers as well. I actually didn't check. How much damage are they doing now? Let's see. 14, 18. Goddamn. So basically, double the damage? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I like to see. Okay, so we're obviously, I think, going to be okay. I don't know how much HP do these guys have. Shield zombie. Oh, shield zombies must be here now, too. Great. Abominations have 150 HP, so you can see they are surviving it a little bit, but they're not getting close enough for me to be worried at all. I think we're okay, so we can focus more on exploring here. So did we? Oh, yeah, I actually expanded that, so I'm slowly expanding this, and I'm just dropping my melee unit down as I expand out my walls. Wave numero 2 is indeed here, and we have the shield guys. So these are the guys that are pretty strong against, did I open? Oh, crap, pull back. This is why I have my shield men here. Exactly why. That's a good thing I heard that. But yeah, we have these shield bearers coming in, which are weak against archers, or strong against archers, I should say. So I should probably bring this melee guy back soon here. He is kind of doing a good job down here, obviously, too, though, so I'll keep an eye out. We're going to continue to expand this out. What is this? Gold miner again. What's up with all the miners right now? I need something different. All right, I want to see if I can take this thing down. I'm a little worried about this guy right here. So yeah, you can see he blocks the vast majority of the shots. Looks like some do indeed get through. And thankfully, he doesn't have much health. Okay, yeah, he's being dropped. I'm not too worried anymore. Oh, look at that explosion, though. Okay, we're gonna have to repair those tomorrow. We'll do the repairing in the morning time. We have more than enough to keep us defended here, at least now, though. And yeah, those explodey guys, they actually work for me because they do so much damage to its allies. Did another one open? Oh my god, it did. Look at this. Look at how unlucky I'm getting, and this is why this guy is down here. Thank you for being down here. And there we go. So we're just gonna continue to expand out this wall. That way I don't need a melee unit down here when I'm exploring. I can just kind of dig downwards and keep everybody else safe. Goddamn. Okay, we're definitely going to need a healer soon here too. As you can see, that was a lot of units in there. Goddamn. Alright, there we go. That's better than nothing. This one's deadly and frail. It does 50% more damage though. That means we got another archer. Good enough for me, man, because I haven't been finding any damage dealers lately. And you know what? These speed upgrade units, I think this will be good as a healer. So I think I'm going to now finally build the healing tower because we definitely need it. Where is it? I don't even know what it looks like because I never use it. All right, temple. There we go. We can put it right in there and we are going to indeed do that. Aha! More iron. Good to see. Good to see. Do we have any jack of all trades units on gold? Gold miner here. Awesome gold mining skills. Okay, I think I got rid of a lot of those guys. Let me show you. Okay, plus one mining anything. So we're gonna, again, we need to get iron right now because we're gonna be expanding out a lot of our units. So the more iron we can get, the better. And this cave is gonna be huge by the end of the day. We should be good now to get this guy out of here. I'm just gonna wait for this final tile and then I'm just gonna start digging downwards. Now we got a new farmer as well, plus two, the best farmer you can possibly get. And there we go. Okay, so that's open. And another iron miner. Should I keep this guy? Yeah, you know what? We're probably going to find some more iron soon here, so I'm going to start digging down this way and bring this guy back to the front lines. Now we have actually a better healer. Healer 2 heals 3 times as fast and can mass heal. So there's actually spells you can do once you're level 2, so that's exciting. And we're going to bring this guy back to the front lines. We'll heal him up once that guy is recruited. What's this guy? Look at her go. 40% faster. Oh, I should have made you my healer. Goddamn. Okay, maybe... what could I use this unit for? You know what? No, I'm just going to get rid of it. Let's not forget about my other archer unit. And that actually reminds me as well. Do I have any builders up top? What is this guy? Oh, that's that new iron miner. All right, you're going to be a builder for a second, buddy, because I need another tower up. We're going to put this tower side by side with the other one. We'll spread it out just a little bit because there is a lot of splash damaging creatures. And if we spread these out just a little bit, that will obviously be a good idea. What is this? Another iron miner. Okay, well, did we find any? Oh, we did find some iron. Look at that. Good timing here, bud. All right, so I'll try and keep that guy safe for as long as I can, and we're just gonna go to this one here, so if I do spawn any goblins, he's safe on his little node mining his iron. But now that we already have another iron miner, I'm just gonna get rid of this guy. Again, I'm very selective right now. We'll upgrade this, upgrade this. We have another archer anyways. Welcome to the crew. I guess I could have got rid of that basic archer, but at this point, I kind of need her. And welcome my little mage. So yeah, we can actually click this, and as you can see, around its aura, it can actually mass heal multiple people. So I'm gonna just try it here. Did it work? Are you guys... yeah, you guys look like you're mass healed now. That was easy. Okay, we'll keep this in between the two towers, obviously. And there we go. We got a healer now as well. Look at that. Another 50% damager. Not as good as 100, but I'm not finding any of those anymore. It's been like 2 days since I found one. So again, we're going to make another archer. If we can get another full archer tower by the end of the day, oh, that would be amazing. 100% more health points. Good old Dick Maiden. Oh, I can't take this game seriously sometimes. But yeah, good old Dick Maiden here. I'll upgrade this to the new melee unit as well, which obviously should be better than these other units. I should be upgrading those guys as well, actually, which we'll do right now. So what is this? Spearman 2. All right, it's just called Spearman 2. Simple enough. It looks like it has a better shield, and obviously it's going to be a better Spearman as well. All right, there's our new Arbalist. Yeah, we'll bring these two guys over. Let's upgrade them as well while we're doing this. And did anybody else come in? All right, we'll check out that guy once these guys get over here. I just want to queue all these up so I don't forget about them. And there we go. There we go. All right, check out that pikeman, man. Oh, that's so cool looking. So yeah, obviously we got a bit more armor now, so that's good. Oh, I got 2 more potions. Where did I get those? All right, we'll put that on good old Dick Maiden. I mean, she's all geared out now, so we may as well double do her. I wonder if... I think those things just popped up, so I think you can have maybe a max of 3 potions. Not really sure. And that's official. We have run out of trees. So what I'm going to have to do, we got lots of trees right at the front of our place here. I only have 1 woodcutter right now, and I'm not having any problems with wood, so I'm not too worried about it. But you can actually buy trees from the merchant. Maybe I should put down the merchant as well. I don't really need anything from it. I wish you could buy potions from it, but you can't. Like I said, I played this a little bit off recording, so I kind of know a little bit more. But yeah, I guess we'll build it. Let's just build that. We're going to build this close to our farm over here, and then I'll just get rid of this guy because he's a decent fellow. He has no perks. How are we doing over here? Found some more iron. Perfect. That's good to see. We'll get that later. We're actually doing okay for iron. At least we're keeping up with it, so not too worried about that. What I'm going to do is mine out this final one, and then we'll mine deeper down here. That way everybody's safe, and we don't need to keep any spearmen inside my mines. Okay, well, there we go. The trades thing is up, so we can ding that bell, and once a day, the tradesperson will come. I feel really bad because I just got this guy to build this and ding the bell, and then I killed him. But now we can actually trade this guy. So I'm not really sure what he gives besides the ability to plant trees. I think you can just trade generic resources. We'll find out really quickly, though. Okay, so yes, you can buy food. So basically, I could merchant if I want to. I can't sell. Oh, no, the cell's down here. I didn't even see it. So yeah, the one thing that's special in here is the magic pine cone to instantly grow a tree for 6 gold. Mind you, I do have lots of gold, so that might be a smart idea just in case I forget about this guy out here. Maybe I'll wait till tomorrow. No, let's just do it. I want to see how it works. Okay, so you literally just plant it wherever you want. Well, I guess we're going to plant a tree there. There we go. Look at that. That is a magic pine cone if I've ever seen one. Now, can we sell anything? I have lots of stone right now. So let's merchant a little bit. I'm going to sell a little bit of this. Mind you, actually, no. I do want to keep my stone because I just remembered if we go into here, we can buy the stone terrace, which will allow us to build upwards, basically. We can build upon our structures above them. So yeah, we'll definitely do that later. Magha's here. Uh-oh. All right, this is actually okay because we have a new unit. Faster than average. All right, get out there. And who else are we going to get rid of? We got a lot of miners right now. Qualified iron miner. I'm going to get rid of you, man, because I'm running out of places for all these freaking miners. And I want to get lots of potions. So let's just make sure we're doing good ones. Stone miner, this guy's too good to get rid of. Plus twos I generally won't get rid of. A basic gold miner might be worth getting rid of. If we can get somebody else to come in quick, that would be great. Actually, who's in the fields right now? A decent farmer. Are you not even farming? Get to work. What the hell? Are you just sitting there? These are all actually farmers, so we're okay with that. I don't have many people to trade, to be honest. So I have two out there right now. Magha's still really far away. I'm trying to figure out who I want to get rid of. A lot of these guys are basic, actually, but I do need to continue to get food. So I'm not going to get rid of too many of them. Skill with the hammer. I don't have many builders right now, so I will keep that. I think 3's a good amount. I don't feel like I would love the idea of, like, getting rid of 50 and, like, max buffing my characters, but I don't know if that's a good idea or not. This guy is just an ordinary builder as well, but he's been building this whole mine. I don't want to get rid of him now. He's MVP. So yeah, I'm getting a little greedy. I'm going to take a risk here. We got lots of food in the bank anyways. I'm going to get rid of this other skilled builder just because I really want to get these potions. Maka's still really far away. Hopefully we can get somebody to come into this place too. Do we have anyone waiting? No, we don't. Come on, come to our village so I can give you to Magha so we can eat you. Oh, that's why no people are coming. We're actually maxed out. So Magha, good timing, buddy. Good timing indeed. What? Why is everybody stopping? Did I never get that guy to hit that? Probably. That's something I would do. Well, we need more space. Let's get another house down. We should be able to fit one in there. We'll just get my farmer to do it. And I don't think I'm going to have time to get anything else to Magha. He's almost there. Yeah, unfortunately, 4's good enough. 4's more than enough, actually, so I'm fine with that. And let's get a spearman out there to collect this stuff once he's done devouring them. I'm seriously curious about killing Magha now, though, because he does have HP. He is killable, but I really don't want to screw with a guy of this power. I mean, he's literally devouring people, so yeah, not the best idea. All right, thank you, Magha. Looks like we got some different potions this time, at least 3 of them. I've only seen 2 so far, so, oh, look at that, 4 of one. So we got, what do we got, 25% more HP. We'll throw that on you, my dude. There you go. Thanks for coming out here. You know what? You can have the armor as well. I don't mind buffing you. 25% more damage. Yes, please. That's what I'm talking about. So yeah, you can definitely see that this is a potion on this guy. So we don't want to give them more than 3, it looks like. This guy's got 3 right here. Let's focus on these guys back here. And we're going to give these guys the damaging potions as well. Technically, that's a jack-of-all-trades potion, but I really want to focus on my damage output. Builds and repairs 3 times as fast. Welcome to the crew, new builder. You're better than any other builder that I've ever seen. So yes, please. And that actually reminds me, I think we can go to floor 4 now since I upgraded. So I didn't actually need to expand out so far. So what we're going to do is, start expanding downwards with this builder. And Tadog, you are MVP, buddy. Are you missing an eye? I never even noticed that, but Tadog is missing an eye, I think. We're gonna have to kill you off, my friend, because, yeah, I just don't need you anymore. And as sad as that is, that's reality, man. Once I don't need you, you're out of here. There we go. We got another fighter. Okay, so how many is that? We got like two in there, I think. So if we can get one more, oh, that would be great. Eight archers would be amazing by day three. I think that would be more than enough to support us. We might want to get one or two more healers, though. But we'll decide as we go. I'm actually running out of food, which is a little worrying. We have these bunnies down here we can kill if we do need a bunch of food real quick. But 218 food really isn't that bad either. We're doing totally fine. You know what? We actually have another 40% speeder. And for some reason, I want my mages to be really fast. So we're going to put this person as another healer. I call them mages, but they're really not shooting anything. So yeah. Getting two healers, I think that will be smart. And we can have one healer healing the melee units and one healer healing the archers, as the archers will be attacked from time to time. Yes, another 100% damage, boy. There we go. Good old Birder here, Ivan Birder. Oh, thank God. Okay, so we got a full thing of archers. Really good at farming. I just got another farmer, too. Oh, yeah, we've hit the mother load. Now, is farming fishing as well? Let's find out. You usually get two per. I want to go see if we can get four per. If that's the case, we'll bring all the farmers down here too, because there's just more food inside the cave, as weird as that is. Oh, and the iron miner is indeed done, so we're going to bring this guy over to the next one. I'll keep an eye out. I want to see if this guy gets four. No, he only gets two. So yeah, farmers are only beneficial if they're actually farming. So now I got to make a decision. Do I want to get rid of one of these farmers? I think these are officially all farmers now. Plus one with farming, plus one. Or do I want to put another farm down? It's already turning nighttime. Plus two with farming. Am I going to be able to even fit another farm? I could put one. Ooh, I can fit it in there. Okay, well, I guess we're going to build another farm just because I have the farmer to do so. Nighttime already, as you can see, and we got some zombie or goblin problems down below. We'll deal with that later. I'm going to continue to expand this out. But yeah, nighttime, and we got to my goal, I think. Where's my other archer? There he is. And we got two full teams of them, so hopefully that's enough to survive this. Oh crap, that's right, I almost forgot about my woodcutter. I think he would have been, oh wow, he actually just, I just remembered it in time. We have the runners today, so every day we're gonna get harder and harder zombies. I'm gonna put this guy on the tree that we built over here. We got some more people coming in. I just wanna see if they're okay with hitting these. These guys are hard to hit with arrows, but with our damage output, oh my God, look at it. I can't wait to see all these arrows shooting at the same time. Yeah, we're totally fine. All right, archers here. This is actually a good time to test if this hill or the towers increase the range of these things. I don't actually know if they do. It looks like they definitely do, because this guy's not shooting at all. Oh, there we go. Oh my God, look at the amount of things coming in. This is, yes! Okay, the back tower is starting to shoot as well now too. So we should be okay. Look at this damage output. This is great. Mind you, these guys are what I'm most scared about, because these guys can hold off for quite a while against my arrow rain. All right, trying to do 10 things at once. Oh God, these guys are getting so close. It's actually getting a little bit uncomfortable. This guy is like right touching them almost. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to start fighting them. Let's bring this healer up a little bit. I want to be within his healing radius. There we go. And just keep an eye out on his health. All right, another explosion. I think we're okay. We survived it, so I can focus on other things once again. God, once you get this big, there's just too much to do. Like, look at this. I got so many recruits coming in. Stone miner at this point. Anything that's not damage, I'm not interested in. We got another damager. We're going to need lots of archers, guys. So, yeah, as many as we can with damage boosts. Another damage dealer. Okay, this is great. I mean, it's only 50%, but it's better than nothing. And what is this guy? This bloke can mine anything with ease. Do we need this for... Yeah, you know what? This guy can actually help. We could definitely use some more miners because we're using so much of my iron, but I have a nice collection of it now, too. All right, deadly and frail. There we go. Get you... I guess we technically need another tower. What I'm actually going to do... Actually, before I make this guy, let's make him make the tower because I can't make it with a melee unit. I'm going to put this one a little bit further back. I want to have like a no man's land here of a bunch of these wooden things. That way, if they do push away from these guys, at least we have one more force to fight against the enemy. All right, now that he's done that, we can actually make him an archer. We'll upgrade this once again. And you guys get the idea. We have our third tower up. And we just need a builder up here. I actually just got rid of a builder. Look at the size of this guy. Oh, this is the one I'm scared about. And there's no defense here now. Okay, I'm definitely going to have to heal. This could get interesting, guys. Come on, man. Damage output. Oh, my God. We're gonna survive it, that's for damn sure. But goddamn, he has some HP. We took him down so quick, though. Another archer done. There we go. So we got 10 archers now with 4 melee units. I think that's a good spread. The war's not over yet, though. My god, look at this. Oh, man, we might even want to pull back and just let the archers do the damage because these are a lot of boomers here. Come on, hit the boomers, hit the boomers. Okay, yeah, pull this guy back, pull this guy back. Oh, you know what? No, I'm going to have to fight him. I'm going to have to fight him. And we're just going to have to heal as much as I can. Heal. Did I kill? Did one die? Oh, my god. Okay, keep the heals going. I'm going to bring this healer back, bring this healer forward. Try and keep the heals going. There you guys go, there you guys go. Pull back, pull back. Oh my god, look at this. Thank god my other tower is actually helping out as well, because I could use all the help I could get. All right, the healers are doing okay though. Whew, I think I lost. Oh god. Yeah, I definitely lost a couple units there. I don't even know who's alive right now. Okay, there's the healer over here. Bring the healer back. Jesus, that was a relentless wave. What are you shooting over here? They're just shooting the ground like idiots. Okay, who do I have left? I got the spearmen too. Actually, I forgot we have archers down here too. Is that just one archer? Okay, yeah, we have one archer down here. So we can throw him in the tower, get him away from the ground. I think we lost one melee unit because I had 4, right? Now I only have 3. So, whoop-de-doo. And is that the last of them? Oh yeah, it looks like it's turning daytime now. So we survived it, guys. Day 3 was not an easy one, but we did it. And that feels pretty damn good. All right, well, I think we're going to wrap up this one here, guys. I think we have a good baseline going. Obviously, got a little uncomfortable there, so we do want to work on our defenses a little bit more. But yeah, I think we got a really good run going for us right now, so I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Grim Knights. Next time, we'll be getting deeper into this and doing Day 4. Thank you so much for watching and liking, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.